Welcome to r/ProRevenge. This is a story of someone getting back at someone with pro revenge after being wrong. And today's first story is, I pulled the ultimate checkmate when my job tried to force me to quit for not returning to work a month after having my baby. I worked 50 plus hours a week managing the accounts and property for movie productions, small productions like Ridiculous 6, mostly Netflix productions. I was hired as the director's and accounting assistant. I found out I was pregnant and notified them immediately so we could be prepared when I went on maternity leave. I went out of my way to make sure they were set by doing a lot of my work in advance. I completed closing up the account for the production on site and setting up the accounts for the new production arriving after my leave. I trained my temporary replacement. I didn't just work up until I went into labor, I went into work while in labor to work an 8-hour day tying up loose ends. I broke my back for this company, often going in on days off or getting out long after my shift ended. I used my car and gas with no compensation. I took company calls outside of work and off the clock. I was beyond a team player. They were covered. My replacement essentially just had to handle their basic request, like opening a locked door, adjusting the temperatures for their office if requested, posting payments, opening mail, and answering phones. I was the director's assistant, but essentially I did the entire position because he always used the excuse of working in the field to stay home. He was on salary. A month to the date out on maternity leave, I was contacted by my employer asking me to return for maternity leave. I still had 2 months of leave left, and the company doesn't provide insurance for the time, so this time was out of my pocket. I stated I could not, as I had complications and medical procedures coming up. I was told a few days later the amount of work that came up, and my declining to return 2 months early left them with no choice but to hire for my position. I knew my rights, so I wasn't worried and took the remainder of my leave. When I returned, they gave me only 2 4-hour shifts a week. Work was 15 miles outside city limits, so I was essentially working for a babysitter and gas. I complied because I was painfully aware they were trying to get me to quit, so they could avoid an unemployment insurance payout. It was time to play checkmate, and at this point with my rights violated, I had the upper hand. They were a small company and didn't have an HR department. They often outsourced questions to the company lawyer in California. Because the laws were different by state and his specialty was not employment claims, the lawyer's advising was very limited. Well, they weren't aware that cutting my hours, by 46 hours a week, my employer just handed me the unemployment they were trying to avoid. In New Mexico, if your employer cuts you from full-time to part-time hours, they're responsible for providing an insurance payout to compensate the difference in wages temporarily. I knew this wasn't going to sit well with the arrogant director, who thought him cutting my hours was going to be the shove I needed to exit the company. I patiently waited for them to receive my paperwork for my claim. They did, and boy did the director let me know he was angry. The state was considering my claim should there be no attesting by the company. The director called me into his office, requesting that we discuss my job duties. He emphasized how little we had coming in, and how financially inconvenient it had to be for me. He was so sympathetic to my situation, and the anguish as a single mother it must be causing me. When I stated I didn't mind, I was more than happy to be there. My conditions of unemployment is, I had to comply to my employer's work schedule and duties, showing that I'm actively trying to be employed. This didn't sit well with him. His manipulation wasn't working as he planned. He then turned serious as he casually mentioned my unemployment claim and proceeds to pull out my documents requesting a response. He tries to convince me that if I proceed with my claim and receive payment, if at any point I am terminated for my performance, I would lose all source of income, unemployment, and the company. He was trying to threaten me. I knew this not to be true and called his bluff by informing him I wished to proceed. He stated to me that if I resigned right then and there, he would provide me a reference in the future moving forward. If you're terminated, you can't use them as a reference depending on the circumstances of termination. But if he fired me, as long as I was complying, I would then receive the full amount of unemployment. At this point, he realized his tactics to intimidate me weren't working and I wasn't budging. He tried to level with me and ask what was needed to get me to leave the company, and I simply stated, "Fire me." Shocked, he asked me if I'm sure that's what I want. I reassure him. I walked out that afternoon with all my belongings and a letter of termination from my employer. I started receiving unemployment insurance the following week, as he didn't contest my payouts. I had a new baby I was able to stay home with a year on my employer's tab. The second story is, fire me for protecting my coworkers, feel the burn in return. So this story is a few years old now, from my first year of varsity. I had started varsity and was doing a pretty hectic course in the medical field. As a child to a single parent who had not worked since I was 15, I obviously needed a job to cover my living expenses and what little my scholarship didn't. So I started working part-time at a bookstore in my local mall as it suited my personality and I love books in general. The bookstore is one of those large-scale corporate chain types. The pay was as close to minimum wage as humanly possible though. So 6 months in, I'm doing well and I get promoted to night manager. Duties involve managing the night staff, most of which are students like myself, and then two late 20 girls, both of which have kids. A week into my being night manager, a directive comes from head office, saying that we're not making enough book sales and that we're obviously not trying. Now, to put it in perspective, this is around the time where Kindles and all the other types of e-readers were becoming popular, so naturally, physical book sales had dropped radically. To remedy this fact, they were sending down a new store manager to take over, and our current store manager would take a minor managerial role. 3 days later, in walks the new manager, a short lesbian woman who hates men and is bipolar, henceforth referred to as Bipolar B, or BB. Needless to say, I walk through the back for our daily shift change meeting, where they introduce her. She greets us all, and then asks all the managers to stay behind, so everyone filters out, leaving the four managers, myself as the night manager, the day manager, the stock manager, and our previous store manager. So next thing, BB turns to me and asks me, WTF am I still doing here? I calmly explain that I'm the night manager. She hears this and looks at everyone else to confirm this. Once they confirm the truth of my words, she looks at me directly and gives us the whole throwdown of how things around here are going to change, nada nada nada. 6 months down the line, nothing much has changed. BB has been nothing but passive aggressive to me, and some others and everyone has noticed, to the point where everyone in our store has a burning dislike for her. The managers get called in for a meeting, where we get told the store is going to be closing in a week for 2 months for a revamp. I immediately ask why the short notice. The night staff all earn on a shift-to-shift basis. A week's notice isn't enough time to make alternative arrangements. BB flips out at me, saying that they don't matter and are easily replaceable. I point out that two of them rely on this job to feed their families, and they can't live without this job. All the other managers stand with me on this point. BB then falls back and says we'll pay them a base wage for 1 month, and then hire them as painters. Now, my neighbor is a painter by trade, and I know they earn at least twice what we're paid per hour. So I point this out as well as ask if she's also going to pay for them to be trained. She then flips out at me further, for being a smart aleck. Okay, maybe I deserve that. Eventually, she says that we'll meet tomorrow to discuss her final decision. The time that she chooses, though, is an hour and a half before my shift starts, and right in the time frame where I have one of my final exams. I point this out, and an evil grin crosses BB's face, and she says to me, if you don't make it in tomorrow, don't bother coming in ever again. A week later, I find out three of my coworkers on night shift were let go with no pay and told to reapply once the store opens. All those who had openly been friendly with me were told not to come back. This included both young mothers. This sends me into a fit of absolute rage. It's one thing to screw with me, but to mess with my coworkers as well, that's too far. I immediately phoned head office to complain and was completely ignored, kept on the line, switched from department to department. Eventually, I had enough and sent in a detailed report to my country's Business Control Council, reporting the corporation, rather than the store, for bad business practice and unfair dismissal of multiple staff members. I then emailed the corporation's HR, explaining what I had done and why. I informed them that I would change my complaint to the name of the store manager, instead of the corporation in general, if they found a way to rectify what they had done. It took 3 days before I received a response. They rented a smaller store for everyone to work at, while the renovations were done, at great expense due to the small timing window, and they had rehired everyone, while suspending BB without pay, until further notice. I immediately kept my promise and edited my complaint. Investigation was done, and BB lost her job permanently, with no chance of a reference. Had worked for said company for 20 years. With a 20-year gap in her CV, it has been very hard for her to find a decent job. I saw her the other day working as a packer in my local supermarket. I realized I had forgotten to get sweet chili sauce, and asked her please to get me a bottle off the shelf. Could not think of anything better to do, as I had flu, and really was not my sharpest, just wanted to get back to bed. She went off scowling but cannot guarantee she recognized me. This is what brought the story to mind. It's been pointed out to me that I may have been a bit harsh here towards people who are lesbian or bipolar. This was not intended, as I know people who are either lesbian or bipolar and are phenomenal people. They were purely just a part of who she was, and I was in full rant mode once I started. I'm putting this here rather than edit the actual post, as I did say those things, and probably deserve the hate that comes with them. The last story is, manager thought my job role was unnecessary, learns the hard way it wasn't. About 20 years ago, I worked in the technology field as a sales engineer, supporting sales reps. A new sales rep manager joined the field team and didn't like the control sales engineers had over the sales process. Because I was the lead sales engineer, he decided to make me an example of his brilliance. He got a very large lead with a bank and proceeded to close a very large deal without involving any sales engineers at all. Just after the deal closed, he called to gloat, saying something to the effect of, the biggest deal this month. Oh wait, you did not participate at all. About a month or so later, I get a call from that manager, in a bit of a panic, and I partake in a conference call with the customer. It is decided I need to come to the company for a meeting. At the meeting, I figure out the sales manager and the sales rep totally effed things up and sold the customer an incompatible set of solutions. In the meeting, I casually mentioned that maybe the customer could return one bit of stuff and replace it with another, as they were roughly the same price. After the meeting, sales manager starts beeing at me for mentioning price. Price was the exclusive domain of the sales reps. He calls my manager, SHs all over me. I didn't like my manager at all, so when he took the sales rep's side, I said F you and quit. I send a very lengthy defense of my actions during the meeting to HR. 4 months later, I get a call from another sales rep still at the company. He asks, hey, what happened at XYZ Bank? They're suing us. I call XYZ Bank and get the email for the CIO and send them a letter explaining I was the sales engineer for the company you're suing. Call me. They eventually sit a lawyer to interview me and get my side of events. My testimony was devastating to my former company's defense. I showed the bank the letter I sent my HR, in which I claim our company lied to the customer to get a sale. Eventually, I get a subpoena to be deposed in the bank versus company lawsuit by my former company's lawyers. By that time, I was working elsewhere and hanging out on Yahoo stock message boards and bashing the company's stock. One day, another sales rep from a distant territory that I still talk to called me to say that a huge deal we had worked on for over a year had just fallen through in dramatic fashion. I posted it to the Yahoo message board devoted to that stock. The stock crashed $13 the next day. I wondered if my post had anything to do with it. About 6 weeks after the stock crash, it's the day before I'm supposed to get deposed in the bank versus company matter. I get served with a lawsuit by the company. They had used the slap laws to get my identity from Yahoo and sue me for the post that crashed their stock. So I went to the deposition the next day and said, I'm sorry, the company you represent today just served me with a lawsuit last night. This deposition is over. They were dumbfounded. Turns out there were two separate legal teams, one working on defending the company against the bank's suit and one finding that pesky internet troll that crashed their stock, and the two never noticed the same person was central to each. The company settled with the bank and dropped their suit against me soon thereafter. That long letter I sent to HR, turns out the managers above me didn't read it. Once the lawsuit was over, the sales rep, the sales manager, and his manager were all fired. Thank you for subscribing and likes.